In a recent interview, the highly esteemed Professor Tim Spector shared how to unlock way more nutrients from broccoli. And perhaps quite surprisingly, he said there's one particular cooking method that can enhance broccoli's health benefits by releasing significantly more sulforaphane. But this way of cooking has been really frowned upon amongst health influencers. But Professor Tim said, quote, "You get 3 or 4 times more sulforaphane when you microwave broccoli than when you heat it." Most people think microwaving is really unhealthy, but actually, in some cases, it can be a real boon because it works differently. So if you combine this with the updated technique Dr. Michael Greger is about to share, you will get the maximum amount of sulforaphane. So why is this so important? Well, sulforaphane found in cruciferous veggies like broccoli and kale offers numerous health benefits, including potential anti-cancer, anti-inflammatory and anti-diabetic effects, as well as benefits for our brain and heart health. It also supports detoxification processes and may help improve digestion. The reason we think sulforaphane has such potent anti-cancer effects is because it can block DNA mutations and slow tumour growth. It can also increase the death of cancer cells and reduce inflammation. So this is why we want to get as much sulforaphane as possible. In a recent Q&A, Dr. Greger shared an update that's going to be added to his soon-to-be-released 10th anniversary edition of How Not to Die regarding that fascinating hold and hack method. So let's take a listen.
You know, when I tell people about hacking and holding, you can maximize the benefit of your kale or your collards or your broccoli by chopping and then waiting 45 minutes or waiting 30 minutes. There's been an update in the new How Not to Die 10th anniversary edition coming out this December. We've learned a lot in 10 years. And one of the things, you don't have to hack and hold. You don't have to wait 45 minutes. You can wait 30 minutes. Anyway, there's really interesting reaction and you get more benefit. But the concern about doing videos like that is that, well, someone's just going to eat less broccoli just because, like, oh, I didn't chop it, so I'm just going to go to Chick-fil-A. I don't want things to be complicated, but that doesn't stop me. I mean, I'm putting it all out there. I'm putting out with the sciences. I'm not holding anything back.
Next, we'll look at one of the most mind-blowing effects of eating broccoli. You really have to hear it to believe it. To view that video, you can click on the middle of the screen now.